We have seen the meaning of directing and the role of communication in directing as a management function. Now, next important aspect is what is the role of supervision and motivation, as the supervision and motivation play a key role in the successful leadership. It is clear that supervision is a vital link between planning and the work on floor. As the execution of the management strategy has various aspects, the supervisor has to perform various roles. A supervisor plays an important role by providing different incentives to workers to perform better. Multiple roles of supervisor. A supervisor plays multiple roles at one time, like number one, as a planner. A supervisor has to plan the daily work schedules in the factory. At the same time, he has to divide the work to various workers according to their abilities. Next, as a manager, it is rightly said that supervisor is a part of the management team of the enterprise. He is, in fact, an operative manager. A factory supervisor leads the workers by guiding them the way of perform their daily tasks. In fact, he plays a role of an inspirer by telling them. Next, as a mediator, a supervisor is called a linking pin between the management and workers. He is the spokesperson of management as well as of worker. Next, as an inspector, an important role of supervisor is to enforce discipline in the factory. For this, the work includes checking the progress of work against the time schedule, recording the work performances at regular intervals, and reporting the deviations, if any, from those. He can also frame rules and regulations which have to be followed by workers during their work. Next, as a counselor, a supervisor plays the role of a counselor to the workers' problem. He has to perform this role in order to build good relations and cooperation from workers. This can be done not only by listening to the grievances, but also handling the grievances and satisfying the workers. Therefore, we can say that effective and efficient supervision helps in serving better work performance, building good human relations, and creating a congenial and cooperative environment. This all helps in increasing the productivity. Now let us see what is motivation. Motivation is one of the important elements of directing. Issuance of proper instructions or orders does not necessarily ensure that they will be properly carried out. It requires manager to inspire or induce the employees to act and get the expected result. This is called motivation. It is a force that inspires a person at work to intensify his willingness to use the best of his capability for achievement of specific objectives. It may be in form of incentives like financial, such as bonus, commission, etc., or non-financial, such as appreciation, growth, etc., or it could be positive or negative. Basically, motivation is directed towards goals and prompt people to act. Now let us see what is importance of motivation. While performing a job, two things are required. One, the ability to work, and next, the willingness to work. Without willingness to work, ability to work cannot produce the result. The importance of motivation lies in converting this ability to work into willingness to work. Performance depends on ability as well as willingness, and willingness depends on motivation. Thus, motivation is a key element in directing people to do the job. Some of other benefits of importance of motivation are like this. Number one, with proper motivation, there can be maximum utilization of the factors of production like men, money, material, etc. Next is, if employees are motivated, it will reduce the employee turnover and absenteeism. Next, motivation fosters a sense of belongingness among the employees towards the organization and also improves their morale. Next is, motivation helps in reducing the number of complaints and naturally grievances. With proper motivational techniques, management can attract competent and best quality employees. Now, let us see how to motivate. After learning about the importance of motivation in directing, you must be wondering as to what is normally done to motivate the employees. Actually, there is no hard and fast rule of motivating individuals in the specified way. Not all individuals are motivated in the same way. It varies from individual to individual. However, on the basis of a lot of research done in the field of motivation, the following must be kept in mind while motivating. Each employee has some needs of his own that he wants to fulfill. While directing, it is essential to ensure that any of unfulfilled need of the individual is being taken care of. Here, we must understand what is a need. A need is a feeling of lack of something, and every person tries to take care of that feeling by satisfying or fulfilling what he lacks. For example, when you are hungry, you eat food to satisfy the lack of food. So, here hunger is your need. The needs of the individual differ from person to person. However, there are certain common needs which are known to exist in most cases. For instance, people have basic needs like the needs for food, clothing, and shelter. These are known as physiological needs. People generally work so as to be able to earn money to satisfy such needs. Once the basic needs are satisfied, people wish to satisfy higher category of needs. They want safety and security and desire to be protected against loss of employment, sickness, accident, etc. These are known as safety and security needs. Thereafter, people want to have a sense of belonging to the organization and to be accepted by fellow workers. These are known as social needs. Similarly, there are people who wish to be considered important and expect that their opinions should be recognized by others. These needs are also known as ego needs. Further, a person may wish to achieve what he thinks is due to him, that is, he wants to realize his ambition fully. These needs are known as self-actualization needs. This is called hierarchy of needs concept of motivation developed by Maslow. It is important to remember that the needs and desires of people change. Once their basic needs are satisfied, others' needs arise. Managers have thus to understand the needs and desires of subordinates and decide how to motivate them. The knowledge of different types of needs enables a manager to adopt different ways to motivate individuals depending upon which need is unsatisfied for the individual. For example, a person whose physiological needs are not fulfilled may be motivated to work with a promise of increasing pay, whereas another person may be motivated if he is given a very challenging job to perform regardless of the pay. In fact, many other approaches have been developed for motivation. But in simple terms, as stated earlier, it is usually in the form of incentives. Not only that, certain factors or job conditions that exist in the organizations, like recognition of work, advancement in career, challenging nature of the work, etc., also motivate the employees. Now, let us see very important aspect of directing, that is leadership. While motivation is the process through which employees are made to contribute voluntarily to work, leadership is the ability to persuade and motivate others to work in a desired way by achieving the goal. Thus, a person who is able to influence others and make them follow his instructions is called a leader. For example, in an organization, the management decides to install some new machines to which the workers are resisting. However, one of the workers takes the initiative, explains the fellow workers the benefits of working with new machines, and molds them to accept the management's decision. Now, he is said to be leader as he is able to influence group of workers who followed him. In practice, the managers have to guide and lead their subordinates towards the achievement of goals, and so to be an effective, a manager has to be a good leader. Leadership is the process which influences the people and inspires them to willingly accomplish the organizational objectives. The main purpose of managerial leadership is to get willing cooperation of the work group in pursuit of the goals. Now, we will see what is the importance of leadership. The objectives of any organization can only be fulfilled if its employees are working towards accomplishment of such objectives. To make people work in the desired manner, proper instructions and guidance is necessary, and this direction process becomes effective when the persons who give such directions have leadership qualities. Leadership is essential in functioning of any organization, and its importance and benefits are varied. Some of the reasons why leadership is important are like this. Number one, leadership improves the performance of the employees. Leaders can motivate the followers to work and thereby increase their performance level. Next, with continuous support and guidance, leaders are able to build the confidence among their followers, thereby increasing speed and accuracy and decreasing the wastage. Next, with friendly and cooperative efforts, the leader is able to build the employees' morale, which is in turn contribute to higher productivity. Now, let us see what are qualities for the good leadership. In order to be successful, a leader must possess certain qualities. A good leader should be professionally competent, intelligent, analytical, and he or she should have a sense of fair play, including honesty, sincerity, integrity and, most important, sense of responsibility. He must possess initiative, perseverance, be diligent and realistic in his outlook. He must also be able to communicate his subordinates effectively. Human relation skills are a must for any leader. Earlier, it was believed that the success or effectiveness of a leader depends on his personal traits or characteristics like physical appearance, intelligence, self-confidence, alertness, and initiative. This is no longer regarded as a correct approach. It has been established on the basis of experiments that the success of effectiveness of a person as a leader depends upon his behavior pattern or leadership style in relation to the followers. To get things done, managers have to influence their subordinates and seek their voluntary cooperation. If their leadership is not based on suitable behavior or style, they will not be successful. When leaders involve people in determining goals and build up team spirit, chances are that people will follow them voluntarily. Now, let us see what you have learned from this. Initially, to get things done, managers have to guide people who work under them, inspire and lead them to achieve common objectives. In order to be able to do so, the managers need to communicate job-related orders and instructions, supervise subordinates at work, and motivate them. These activities of a manager are known as directing. Directing is thus concerned with instructing, guiding, and inspiring people in the organization to achieve its objectives. Its important components are communication, supervision, motivation, and leadership. Communication is the process by which a person transmits information or message to the another person. The process facilitates the task of issuing orders and instructions to convey the superior's ideas about work to be done by the subordinates. It also helps in conveying policies, procedures, and decisions to the employees. The flow of communication can either be upward or downward. It can be formal as well as informal. When it takes place among managers of the same rank, it is known as horizontal communication. When communication is made between people who are neither in the same department nor at the same level of organizational hierarchy, it is known as diagonal communication. Communication may be in the form of oral or written or even non-verbal like gesture. Now, supervision involves seeing that subordinates perform the work as per the instructions given. Supervisors clarify all instructions and guide people to work as a team in cooperation with each other. Though supervision is necessary at all levels of management, it is of great importance at the first level. It is at this level that supervisors are in direct contact with the employees. Supervisors are in key positions in the hierarchy of management. They act as a link between higher level managers and workers. Inspiring people to work is another important component of directing function. This is known as motivation. Motivation requires the use of means to fulfill the needs and desires that may inspire individuals to apply their best abilities to work. Needs of people differ from individuals to individuals, but there are certain common needs felt by most people, such as the physiological needs, need for safety and security, social needs, ego needs, and self-actualization needs. Manager has to find out the unsatisfied needs of the employees and accordingly decide to motivate them. Motivation helps managers in getting things done more efficiently by the employees. If the employees are motivated, they will fully utilize the production facilities and put in their best efforts in performing the job. In order to get things done, a manager has to be a good leader. Leadership is the ability to persuade others to work in a desired way. Thus, a person who persuades others and makes them follow his instructions willingly is called a leader. To be a good leader, a person must possess certain qualities like professional competence, intelligence, ability to analyze, honesty, sincerity, and integrity, etc. Now, before concluding this lecture, let us see what we have learned. Managing is about dealing hands-on with the design, implementation, and maintenance of prudent control systems. But directing is about showing the way ahead and leading. Both are necessary for healthy organizations, but they require very different attitudes, knowledge, and skills, especially in the approaches to thinking. Directing is concerned with instructing, guiding, supervising, and inspiring people in the organization so as to enable them to achieve its objectives. It is the process of telling the people what to do and facilitating them the enthusiastic working environment in which they can achieve the organizational goals in the predetermined manner. Directing initiates action, and it is from here the actual work starts. Direction is said to be consisting of human factors. In simple words, it can be described as providing a guidance to workers in doing the work. In the field of management, direction is said to be all those activities which are designed to encourage the subordinates to work effectively and efficiently. Communication and supervision play extremely important role in the process of directing. Communication is said to be the blood of the organization. It can be verbal, non-verbal, oral, written, gestural, upward, downward, horizontal, or diagonal. Supervision is the activity required at all the levels of management. First line supervisors are the most important ladder in the organizational hierarchy. Supervisor needs both interpersonal skills and technical skills, as he is the person who is shouldered with the responsibility of converting plan into an action. Thank you.